Welcome back to my show. Today we are making a sweet treat. That's gajar ka halwa. It's an amazing treat during winters. So the best thing about this is that there are only two main ingredients, that is grated carrot and some boiled milk. So you can use any carrots, you can use the normal red carrots also. So here, just make a pan hot. If you want, you can put butter or ghee if you want, but I'm just going to make it without any butter or ghee because I don't like that taste so much. So, and the other ingredients which you will need is sugar, cashew nut, and almond. So you can do it without that also, and some sugar. So now the pan is hot, and I'll see you when the carrot is halfway cooked in the pan and then it's time to boil the milk with it.
Put the carrot in. Now you've got to give it a good stir because you don't want the juice to go out of this carrot. So stir it well until it's half cooked and then put the milk in. Now I put the milk and give it a good stir. Now I've taken 1/2 liter of milk with I think about 10 carrots. And remember, when you're cooking these grated pieces of carrot, you should always remember one thing, that the carrot becomes a bit smaller than how it is before cooking. So you should have a lot of grated carrot. And if you're making it for a party, you should always serve it at tea time. It's a grand snack.
Giving it a good stir, put it at high and leave it to cook. And when the milk is boiling, you should always remember, don't think that something wrong has happened if the milk becomes red or something, because the carrot's color is going to come in the milk. That's going to make your gajar ka halwa perfect.
Now the milk has evaporated and only a bit is left. So now put some cashew nuts in for a nice crunch. If you want, you can break the cashew nut also. And now we are going to put a bit of sugar. You can put sugar according to your own taste.
Now the milk is almost all of it is evaporated. Now we don't want this gajar ka halwa dry, so I'm going to close the flame when there's still a bit of milk. So just look at this gajar ka halwa. It's such a precious treat. It takes a lot of work also to make it, but it's easy if you do it, if you're going to eat it. So just put it in a nice bowl and rest. Let it rest for 5 minutes before serving it. So I'm going to keep this for 5 minutes and then I'll see you on the dining table.
Now the gajar ka halwa is ready. I'll taste it and tell you how this is. Looks too good by the looks of it. This is too good. And you know, this is best served when it's hot, and this is just too good.
This halwa is so good that I even ate some of it before the recording.
So bye everyone, I'll see you in my next video.